Okay, the idea of African countries putting themselves together and exercise a global pressure against that court, which was supposed to include even the massive retirement, I think that idea has to continue. Because African countries are not incapable of changing the orientation of ICC, but if they menace it, they exercise the threat of getting out it massively. I think we have some 53, 4 countries of Africa. The world can be frightened and change something. If not, they can retire, get out from it, and organize reform, what I can call African internal justice, enhance mechanisms of justice within institutions such as East African Community, for example, enhance mechanisms of justice within AU, African Union, enhance justice mechanisms with other sub-regional and regional institutions. We are capable. We are keeping, instead of continue undergoing something we are not we do not agree with. I think we as Africans, under the guidance of our head of state, we can exercise the pressure. If they hesitate to operate the forms, Africans can animate their African internal mechanisms of justice, and then maybe this will be sufficient to convince the rest of the world to put in place a genuine international court of justice.
But do you see unity? Because some African countries are in support of the ICC, and you're saying that African heads of states need to lead their peers in pushing for a massive pull out of the ICC or out of the Rome Statute. Do you see unity? Do you see this happening?
Okay, unity can't come automatically. Unity is something to be prepared, to be created. And I think that if the countries which understand exercise enough efforts, they shall bring slowly, slow by slow, other countries to join the useful orientation for Africa. Rwanda, for example, you know we have a good head of state. He has a good surrounding. Uganda has good ideas, Kenya and so on. This core team can exercise, undertake a campaign of convictions, of sensitization, and at the end of the process, we Africans, we can choose the orientation which profits to us. It is a matter of time and of strategies, and it implies much more diplomacy than strength. But you have to think, and you have enough facilities to do it, and at the end, we can put in place good mechanisms and put in place good strategies proper to convince the other countries to agree only a genuine international court of justice.
Is there any worry that doing that will be risky without having an alternative already in place, you know, alternative to the ICC? Because the ICC, according to the creators, was to ensure that crimes against humanity are not actually performed or those who are responsible are held to account. But we still seem not to have those African institutions in place, or strongly so, to offer that alternative. So pulling out without this alternative, does it pose a risk to the citizens of Africa who could fall prey or victims of these crimes against humanity?
Okay, you know, the idea or the concept of ICC is good, but the reality is nothing. So now, the ICC, like it is something harming African countries and African citizens. So if they pull themselves out, they lose nothing, because we are losing already as Africans. We are undergoing a kind of marginalization, segregation, discrimination. So we have to react against. And when if we get out to the court, we lose nothing. On the contrary, we earn something because citizens from our countries will no longer be menaced of being victims of justice, which is not one, the one. So as for alternatives, mechanisms exist. Maybe they are not animated enough. What we can do is to reflect, to think how to make them more effective, to bring to them what they are lacking. Otherwise, within each African institution, be it at the level of the whole continent or at the level of sub-regions and regions, there are mechanisms for justice. What is needed to put substance within them? And this is easy. It is a matter of awareness. And as I said, a campaign has to be conducted of sensitization, and everybody does. It's possible. And you assume our independence in everything, including injustice.